Hey guys, so I wanted to do a kind of video I don't really do that much, and that is hardware reviews. Well, at least hardware reviews of things that have been made in the past 8 years or so. But I got this webcam a couple days ago, I guess I've had it a week or so, and my feelings on it are so positive that I sort of wanted to do a little video on it. So this thing here is a Logitech HD webcam. It is, C920, I don't know if you can read that, but I had to write it in my hand, but, you know, the model number isn't super important because other Logitech webcams are pretty similar. I got this thing because I wanted a decent quality webcam to record on my computer, and this thing has actually blown away my expectations. So if you're someone who, say, is, you know, looking for something to ask for Christmas, I mean, I wanted to do this video before Christmas, of course, and you want to get your mommy to get you something because you have delusions of being a YouTube star, this might be the best thing. I bought this for about 50 bucks. I think that's par for the course. I think it's definitely worth it. So anyway, this thing, you know, when I first got it, well, let's just look at features. So as you can see, it sort of folds out. You can have it just on a desk or something like that. One thing I was originally worried about is its ability to clip on different laptops and screens, but the design here is actually extremely good and it's very sturdy. I mean, you can't feel it, but like it's very sturdy. So it pretty much can go on any laptop I've run into or screen pretty snugly. You just unfold it in whatever way is best, and it's, I don't know, it doesn't really move that much. It's a nice quality design in terms of that. So this is an HD webcam, I guess originally I wanted to sort of use this in a couple screencasts and stuff, maybe take pictures with it, just different stuff like that. And I've used it a couple times and it's already been great, but I should give some caveats. Well, let me say this first. It does work out of the box on Windows and Mac and Linux is of course what I'm running. It does work on totally free Linux distributions, so if you have, you know, whatever, Parabola or Trisquel or something, it should work fine. You shouldn't have to install anything. You just get it out of the dev folder and that's fine. So I've been using this thing and it's pretty convenient for that. There are also some like added perks that I guess I didn't expect. Well, actually, let me do the bad stuff first. Which isn't really bad, considering 50 bucks is, you know, not that much. I will say, and this might not be a fault of the webcam, it might be my fault, but I've had a little trouble. When I use this thing, usually I use the, 640 by 480 or whatever like that, a lower resolution, because I usually have the camera, like, in a side of my screen when I'm recording something. So I don't usually use the HD, webcam resolution. I have tried using it, and I will say on my machines, it's a little stuttery. I don't know if that's just because, keep in mind, I do use computers that are around 10 years old. They take a while to, do rendering and stuff like that. So it might not be the fault of the webcam, so I don't really want to detract points from that. It can very easily, I still can take a video that's sped up over, HD quality and should be fine, but you know, it might just be my I don't quite know how webcams work on Linux, besides the resolution, it works out of the box. Like if you're using Linux, you can just run MPV on dev video zero and this thing's gonna pop out, albeit not at the HD resolution, at a more manageable one. So in terms of perks, there are a lot of nice little things. For example, we got a tripod mount, so I can mount this thing on the tripod I'm recording this on right now and use it, so that is very convenient. Additionally, one of the huge benefits, and this is one of the reasons I actually ended up liking this thing a lot, is I didn't expect it to actually have a microphone. And if it had a microphone, I didn't expect it to actually be good. So I use one of those enormous Blue Yetis to record audio. Actually, let me show you what it looks like. Yeah, this thing. So I use this to record audio in my videos. And I think, you know, it's a decent quality product. You can change the volume, you got a couple settings and how it picks up audio. It's a really nice thing and it picks up good, you know, good sound, I guess. So I do use this for my videos and I've been using it really since I started my YouTube channel. This was around 100 bucks. I might do a video on this later, but I will say I was not expecting So I'll go ahead and say the quality of the audio of this is less than the Blue Yeti, but it is not noticeably less in most circumstances. So if I'm just recording on the screen, this thing works pretty much as well as the Blue Yeti. In fact, there have been a couple times when I was just recording and I didn't realize my computer was recording off this rather than the Yeti, and I didn't really notice it. I had to think about it. Now, if you play the sound from the Blue Yeti and this back, you know, right next to each other, you will notice the Blue Yeti's is noticeably crisper. But depending on the acoustics of your room and, you know, depending how, you know, I'll say if you have a decent room with decent acoustics, this thing is going to work just as well. And of course, as I said before, this thing was $50. This thing was $100. So if you want to just like start screencasting or something or start making videos, this thing is probably, this is definitely sufficient. Just this $50 investment is enough. That's not to say I don't recommend, you know, other audio quality, you know, higher audio quality stuff, but yeah, this is pretty much good enough. So that's one of the reasons I really like this thing. So I'm going to be going on vacation over December and some of January, and when I do, I used to lug this thing around everywhere I went through airport security and stuff like that, but I'm not going to do that this time. I'm just going to take this and we're just going to record video on that and audio included, and hopefully that'll be fine. I definitely think it will be. So anyway, this has been the Logitech, I gotta look it up again, hold on, C920. There are later versions of this, there are earlier ones, so you might want to check those out as well. But I recommend this. The only fault, I said, might not be, you know, the issue of the webcam itself. It might just be, I don't know exactly how to, if you guys know how to do webcamming on Linux and get the resolution you want at the frame rate you want, just tell me in the video description. I'm sure some of my subscribers know, but actually it's pretty sufficient for what I'm doing if I just use the base resolution, and that works fine for me. So aside from that, pretty crisp video and audio. I'm actually really surprised about this, so you might want to actually check it out and get one for yourself if you have, again, if you have delusions of being some kind of YouTube star. So anyway, that's about it.